Abia Warriors took to the pitch on Sunday afternoon, knowing that a win over Sunshine Stars could see them climb to the top of the Nigerian Professional Football League table. The match also pitched Abia Warriors coach Kennedy Boboye against the side he managed last season. Sunshine Stars, playing in orange and white hoops, took the match to their host early on, but Okiki Afolabi failed to punish an error by Warriors captain Austin Oborapo. Warriors Valentine Nwabili then hit the post off a cross by Bolaji Saki in the first meaningful attack for the home team. But it was Sunshine who took the lead courtesy Razak Adebite after yet another error in the Warriors' defense. Sunshine Stars held on to the 78th minute, but Abia Warriors substitute Opina Unwaimo connected a cross by Michael Olaha to draw the home side level. With fans already resigned to a drawn game on the dot of 90 minutes, Sunshine Stars striker Dele Olorundari dispossessed Indifreke Epion of the ball before beating Warriors keeper Chinedu Anozie to send the stadium into utter shock. It was Sunshine Stars' first away victory of the season, condemning Abia Warriors to their first home defeat of the campaign.
And that feat was achieved no thanks to the superlative performance, the excellent performance, the wonderful performance to the Dan Ayam Stadium in Owerri. They went, they saw, and they conquered. Not all added to their haul. It is Sunshine Stars up against 3SC. Quickly, let me take you through the list of the two sides. It is the normal routine for Sunshine Stars. Wherever they go, and supporters club, solid supporters club, you must say, with the latest initiative, Camp 2. Go!
the producer here in Lafayette. In Sunshine Stars 2, Chidi Stars of the Battle, 0. Benny Alandai, Legend Close Corner. Today, at peace in
Sarah. Sarah.
Sunshine Stars are one of the outsiders for the NPFL title this year. The visit of Niger Tornadoes presented the Akure Gunners a chance to enhance their credentials and send warning signs to the team above them. The Owena Waves have made the Akure Township Stadium one of the most difficult places to visit, and the fact that opponents Niger Tornadoes arrived the compact venue as the only side yet to pick up a point away from home this season made Sunshine clear favourite for the 3 points. But it was the visitors who first came closest to scoring, as Lukman Mohammed robbed Sunshine keeper Ojolon Rileke off the ball, but he selfishly shot off target. It should have been Tornadoes opening the scoring minutes later, but Kunle Issa could not connect cleanly with Wilfred Angel's cross. 35 minutes into the match, Samad Quadri missed a good opportunity to put Sunshine ahead from a ball by strike partner Dele Olorundari. Just as both teams prepared to wrap up the opening half, Michael Egbeta struck for Sunshine Stars from a pass by Seun Olulayo. Sunshine Stars began the second half with the momentum with which they ended the first. A terrific shot by Kende Adedigbe bounced up the woodwork, although Nodari's reaction was then tipped over by the Tornadoes goalkeeper Nobas Omorigi. In the 49th minute, Sunshine got their second of the day through Quadri, who made up for his first half miss. Twelve minutes to full time, Tornadoes were almost gifted away back into the match through an error by Olorunleke Ojo, but Tasiu Lawal wasted the chance. It ended 2-0 in favour of Sunshine Stars, who claimed 4 points from Tornadoes this season, having drawn 2-2 in the reverse fixture. The live game of Match Day 22 took place in Akure, the home of Sunshine Stars. The Owena Waves have steadily climbed up the table after a poor start and went into the match unbeaten in 4 matches. Opponents Lobi Stars were just above them on the log. Here are the highlights from the Akure Township Stadium.
And may their gentle souls rest in perfect peace. Nigerian football, it's been a really weak of mourning. Took only 3 days in between Stephen Keshi and Modu Shuaibu, coach that qualified Nigeria for 2 World Cups in 2002 and 2010. A really sad times in Nigeria football. But we're up here when it comes to the Sunshine part of football, a game that is played on the turf. Sunshine Stars against Lobi Stars. To get a ball into the box, ball in the box, and a good header hits the post. Oh, finally, it's almost cleared, but still looking there and now ball completely out of danger. Lobby Stars, the smile, good clearance from Tiakase. David, get away from your picture, two players down, one from either side.
A very intelligent move there. Okemute was well beaten by that header on that occasion, but combination of headers, especially one by Agbaji Anthony, sort of got her out of danger, but he had no attempt at this one. Wonderful header there, very, very agile.
Oh, that's a mistake from Elias Aliasu. He was just there dilly-dallying with the ball, not too sure what to do with it. Another look at that again. As you can see there, Eliasu didn't quite know what to do. Confusion on his part. Bumped into Tony Okpotu, who he had given the ball almost on the platter. It's going to be a free kick to Lobby Stars, and I expect a card or sub to Eliasu. So four-man wall of defense form there, and here it comes. Oh, just inches away from target. That was a very good free kick from Nanemi Menge.
I'm not surprised, Ralph. We saw him bend free kicks from this angle into the net, especially at the Federation Cup final at the Teslim Balogun Stadium last season. So Nanemi Menge, a Nigerian international, has that ability. Perhaps one of two things he picked from his dad, the great Barnabas Menge.
A good turn, he gives the ball away, but he quickly get back possession. This is Abe. Good change of mind from Abe. And now Mine Ojo tearing away. Mine is in the box. An opportunity. Oh, good goalkeeping there, but it's not done finally. Goalkeeper came with the order. And I just see the players on the bench are almost thinking that it's time to celebrate, but not yet.
It was Okiki who let go of Ojomino on that occasion. And Ojo squared it for no other person than Olorundare. All Olorundare should have done was to put more power. But despite his rolling in, he had twice an opportunity to hit it. But then goalkeeper Okemute Oda twice saved two shots from the former Tam Stanley striker, talking about Olorundare.
Despite the fast-paced football that we have seen all through, the chances have not been quite as many as we expected. Lobby Stars are trying to create one though, and here it comes. Opportunity comes. Eze had his leg to the ball, weakened it before the goalkeeper picked that one up. Move from Ikoku.
That's Ikoku with the ball. But a good work so far from Nani. So Nani who saw it at the other angle, he had to square it. Ikoku trapped it. The shot was sort of, the pace, the power behind the ball was taken off by Eze's trap. And then it wasn't too much of a problem for Arroyo to gather.
Now, Aliasu. He's got a long diary there. Now, opportunity for Sunshine Stars. Oh, Aliasu. Stronger play from Mine Ojo. Aliasu was far from it. But Mine Ojo, he should have done better.
That is a defender, perhaps accounted for that. If you are an attacker, he perhaps would have been able to play that ball.
Let's see. Mine's corner kick headed out quickly. Wow, the short comes in. A fly there from Ojo. Ball was completely off target. Bench. Right, thinking it will go in.
That was Dayo Ojo. He's known to have the ability to strike the ball wonderfully, but he didn't properly balance on this occasion. Had he been able to do that, perhaps we just have been talking about the first goal.
Konake comes in. Opportunity for it to be sent back into the box. Lobby Stars, the ball in the box now. Agbaji!
Oh, that was really deceptive.
contact with the post. The goalkeeper thought he was almost in there already, but good, he saved.
Now, I was raving lyrical about this guy in the first half, that he marshaled his team like a captain from the back, but decided to go forward and teach the attackers how to do it. Talking about Tony Adaji, he rose mercurially, picked his angle, dropped the ball. Unfortunately, he chose to hit the upright to the relief of Ariyo David in goal for Ariyo to catch. That otherwise would have been the first goal. Expertly tucked in by captain of Lobi Stars, talking about Adaji Anthony.
Here is Danemi Menge. Now Lobi Stars are turning on the magic. Ikeoku, all in balls. Menge, Menge! Oh, the goalkeeper doing a great job again. Rio David saving the home side, the Sunshine Stars. This opportunity beckoning now for Ongari. Scored down just on the line. Free kick. You know, a couple of Lobi Stars players had their hands in their heads thinking that they were, it would have been a penalty call, but no.
Not really, he worked for it. But Ayagba told that finally, was adjudged to have infringed the ball. He walked, look at how he gathered the ball. He tried to possess the ball, weave an opening around it. And as soon as he was charged upon, trust Olorundare to go down. Well, you have to, like, when you have Ojo and the light in front of the ball, expect a delta, perhaps, from Sunshine on this occasion.
Goalkeeper Kimuje Oda. Last season it was between the sticks for Warri Wolves. Now here, between the sticks for Lobi Stars, team from Makurdi, and he's got job to do. So Gbede will be hoping that this ball will kiss the net for the goal. Everyone here expecting. Fans wonder how they will cheer if eventually this ball hits the net. There is Polabio Kiki there. There is Ojo there. Mine. So Kiki Apolabi. Oh, that ball well defended. Poor clearance there from Rafael. Singing O'Shea, O'Shea, O'Shea Baba. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That's telling the man above.
Well, quite contentious. Anthony Adaji and Okiki Afolabi. Yes, the players were talking at themselves, but not enough reason. I thought Okiki went aground suddenly. But referee Isiaku Ndebawa is of the opinion that an infringement against Okiki, and therefore came with a order in goal for Lobi, has to face this penalty. Coach Kayo Dedier just cannot wait for this kick to be taken.
It's one thing to get a penalty, another thing to put it in the net. It's going to be Olulayo against goalkeeper Kemute Oda. Mine Ojo goes down in prayer. But it is Okiki Apolabi. Hoping to add to his 12th this season. Kiki Apolabi against Okemute Oda. Kiki, Kiki scores. Goal number 13 for Kiki Apolabi. And the stadium has gone bonkers here. The stadium to be brought aground by the fans cheering and celebrating.
Okiki making it call number 13 for himself as he sent Okemute Oda the wrong way from the penalty spot. There are 3 minutes left of play and the fans are beginning to sing Oshie Oshie Baba. That's telling the relief what this goal meant to them. They prayed for it, they worked for it, and look, he earned it. As you see, Agboy Ekoh jubilating.
Against his former club, he shot a jubilative verse. Looking for Okeke again. Okeke in the box. Should have been a yellow card at least for Kiki Apolabi.
Just like Olorun Dare could have gotten a yellow in time past for doing the same.
Opportunity again. Samad. He didn't realize quick enough where he was and the kind of chance that he had there.
Quick thinking then, but directing the ball was poor by Samad. He had the ability. He should have put the goal behind his brain, the picture of the goal behind his brain. That would have aided him. In trying to beat Okemu the other.
Corner kick comes. And it's headed. Goalkeeper catches that one. It will be all over now. Rugby allows us a few seconds more. Ball threaded. Obotu is there. But that ball dealt with by Aliasu. Head of the back play. This is dead man. Rugby starts. They came. They fought. But at the end, a cheap penalty given away.
And so, a controversial penalty was what separated the Battle of the Stars, won by Sunshine. Sunshine Stars have been tough to beat this season. They have lost just 5 matches in the entire campaign, and they came into their match day 24 fixture against MFM FC having lost none of their last 4 matches. MFM were still smarting from last weekend's home defeat to Shooting Stars and were keen to avoid back-to-back losses against Southwest rivals. Sunshine had the first real chance of the match as Stanley Okoronkwo whipped an inviting ball into the box, but none of the onrushing Sunshine players could make a telling contact. MFM really should have taken the lead when John Okoye found himself one-on-one with the Sunshine keeper. The chip was the right idea, but it needed to be an inch lower. Okoye had a more difficult chance in the second half, and again, he could not direct his efforts on target. The deadlock was eventually broken in the 72nd minute when Dele Olorundare's free kick found the back of the net. MFM keeper James Ayiyemi was perhaps put off by the slight deflection of the wall, but he still should have done much better. The home team then had a chance to kill off the contest when the referee pointed to the spot, having spotted handball in the MFM box. The visitors protested sternly, but the decision had already been made. Dele Olorundare stepped up to complete his brace. After a slow start, Sunshine Stars have crept into the top 5. 6 points off the lead in the Nigerian Professional Football League log, and with a game in hand too. They could well be in the mix when the title race hits the home stretch. Plateau United have found some joy in their travels in recent times, winning 2 of their last 4 trips outside Jos. They travelled to Sunshine Stars on match day 35, looking to pile more misery on their Akure team, whose run of 3 matches without a win has effectively put paid on any real hopes of them winning the NPFL title this season. Sunshine took the lead when Dele Olorundare showed quick reactions to turn home amidst static Plateau defenders. Thank you. The lead was doubled when Kadiru Samad superbly met Sunday Abe's free kick, and he had a celebration to match the goal. Plateau United gave themselves a lifeline with this header from Kabir Omar in the 51st minute. But their hopes of a comeback were extinguished when the referee awarded a penalty after spotting a handball in the box. Olorun Dare stepped up to complete his brace. It ended in favor of Sunshine Stars as the Owena Waves picked up their first win in four NPFL matches. Rivers United are one of the teams with decent shouts of title glory this season. Their trip to the Akure Township Stadium, home of Sunshine Stars, was seen as pivotal to the race at the top end of the log. Rivers knew a win here could take them level on points at the very top, depending on results elsewhere. But it was Sunshine Stars who fired the first salvo through Dele Olorundare. His shot in the 6th minute was saved by Rivers keeper Rotimi Sunday. Six minutes later, Dayo Joe was also denied by Rotimi. United responded with an effort from Okafor Onyekachi, but the Sunshine Stars goaltender was alive to the danger. Ayo Saka then found himself unmarked, but he flopped the chance to put the host in front. Sunshine eventually took the lead 5 minutes before the break following a foul on Abiodun Joseph. Dele Olorundare's free kick was beyond the reach of Rotimi as the stadium rejoiced. The second half was largely uneventful, and it was Saka who missed the clearest chance to double his team's lead. Sunshine saw out their lead to claim the important points at stake and dent Rivers United's title charge.